Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God, of thy bountiful goodness, keep us, we beseech thee, from all things that may hurt us, that we, being ready both in body and soul, may cheerfully accomplish those things which thou commandest. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost art one God, world without end.
Amen. The epistle is written in the fifth chapter of Ephesians, beginning at the 15th verse. See then that ye walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. Wherefore, be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. And be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 22nd chapter of the Gospel according to Saint Matthew, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven is like unto a certain king, which made a marriage for his son. And he sent forth his servants to call them that were bidden to the wedding, and they would not come. Again, he sent forth other servants, saying, 'Tell them which are bidden, behold, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and my fatlings are killed, and all things are ready. Come unto the marriage.' But they made light of it and went their ways, one to his farm, another to his merchandise, and the remnant took his servants, and entreated them spitefully and slew them. But when the king heard thereof, he was wroth, and he sent forth his armies and destroyed those murderers and burned up their city. Then saith he to his servants, 'The wedding is ready, but they which were bidden were not worthy. Go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as ye shall find, bid to the marriage.' So those servants went out into the highways and gathered together all, as many as they found, both bad and good. And the wedding was furnished with guests. And when the king came in to see the guests, he saw there a man which had not on a wedding garment. And he saith unto him, 'Friend, how camest thou in hither, not having a wedding garment?' And he was speechless. Then said the king to the servants, 'Bind him hand and foot, and take him away, and cast him into outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many are called, but few are chosen.'"
Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God,
begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end.
And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified,
who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins,
and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As you can see, the saints are numbered in the bulletin for this week, and actually we're going to be kind of celebrating our patron this week on the weekday, but we are going to have the patronal feast celebrated next Sunday. So read up on Saint Luke, physician and evangelist, just an all-around saintly man. And then come back this next Sunday and we'll do the patronal celebration of the Feast of Saint Luke.
Thank you.
Last year at this time, I focused my homily exclusively on the gospel, the parable of the wedding feast. I noted that the parable is a foreshadowing of the great marriage supper described in Revelation chapter 19. There, it is made clear that unless we have put on the Lord Jesus Christ, as Paul instructs us to do in Romans 13, verse 14, and we are wearing a robe washed in the blood of the Lamb, we, like the unfortunate guest in the parable, will be cast out into the outer darkness, or as Revelation 20, verse 15 calls it, the lake of fire. Jesus did not shy away from speaking hard truths, and the parable of the wedding feast is an excellent example of that. We were having technical difficulties last year, so you won't find that homily on our YouTube channel, so if you would like a copy, let me know. The epistle is chock full of advice on how to live a life that demonstrates that one has, in fact, put on the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want to focus especially on the advice, which is really a commandment, found in verses 19 and 20. Speak to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Notice the critical phrase, giving thanks always. It is easy to give thanks when things are going well and we are experiencing showers of blessing, in the words of the prophet Ezekiel and the old hymn of that same name. But is it really possible to give thanks when we are discouraged, doubtful, sick, or simply worn down by the cares of life? The answer is an emphatic yes. When Job lost everything, family and possessions, he praised God, proclaiming, "The Lord gave, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." At the Last Supper, knowing what horrible suffering awaited him in just a few hours, Jesus sang psalms of praise with his disciples. According to Jewish tradition at Passover celebrations, this almost certainly included singing either Psalm 118 or Psalm 136, both of which begin with, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, because his mercy endureth forever." After Peter and the apostles had been flogged by order of the Jewish authorities for preaching the gospel, they left, quote, "rejoicing that they were counted to be worthy to suffer shame for Jesus' name," unquote. Similarly, when Paul and Silas were also thrown into prison in Philippi for preaching the gospel, they prayed and sang hymns in the presence of the other prisoners. We see by these examples that offering up a sacrifice of prayer and thanksgiving, especially in difficult and trying times, is characteristic of those who are firmly rooted and grounded in their faith. So I want to suggest five canticles, psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs used in worship, and a prayer that should be in everyone's thanksgiving toolbox, ready to use at a moment's notice. Unfortunately, time won't allow us to review each of those in their entirety. You're already familiar with the first suggestion because we recited it just a few minutes ago at the beginning of the Mass, the Gloria in Excelsis. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, Heavenly King, God the Father Almighty. This ancient hymn of praise dates back to the 4th century. Massey Shepherd, in his prayer book commentary, calls this canticle a kind of praise shout to the glory of God and the coming of his salvation to men through the Messiah Redeemer. Next, we look at several canticles found in the daily offices. Feel free to follow along in the prayer book in your pew. First is the Venite at page 9. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. The Benedicite is comprised of the first seven verses of Psalm 95, then two verses from Psalm 96. Shepherd calls this a jubilant summons to the whole world of nature and man to worship its creator, provider, and judge with joy and with thanksgiving, in beauty and in awe. Next is the Te Deum, found at page 10 of the prayer book. We praise thee, O God. We acknowledge thee to be the Lord. All the earth doth worship thee, the Father everlasting. This ancient hymn of praise dates back to at least the 4th or 5th century and sometimes has been used as a complete worship service in itself. Another canticle of praise, especially appropriate during a time of stress or anxiety, is the Benedictus Est, found at page 11 of the prayer book. Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers, praised and exalted above all forever. Blessed art thou for the name of thy majesty, praised and exalted above all forever. I say this is especially appropriate in times of stress or anxiety because it is the song that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego sang when they were tossed into the fiery furnace by King Nebuchadnezzar and ultimately emerged unscathed. One can easily imagine this being one of the hymns that Paul and Silas sang while in prison. A fifth canticle of praise and thanksgiving, the Jubilate, is found at page 15 of the prayer book. And it is simply Psalm 100. O be joyful in the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. And a final recommendation is the general thanksgiving, which concludes both morning and evening prayer. You'll find one example at page 19. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. This is where we give God thanks for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. In just a few minutes, we will hear the celebrant remind us that it is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto God, the very same thing Paul instructs us to do in today's epistle. The ability to do this is one of the surest signs of spiritual maturity. Having these psalms, hymns, and prayers firmly implanted in your memory will allow you to do so as naturally as breathing air. Your assignment, to be accomplished before the end of this liturgical year, the Feast of St. Andrew on November 30th, is to memorize the Gloria, the Venite, the Te Deum, the Benedictus, the Jubilate, and the Prayer of Thanksgiving. The best way to do so is to regularly pray the daily offices, as the bishop urged us to do in his homily last week. But more than that, make it a habit to recite them throughout the day, while on a walk, during a long drive, or in the middle of a sleepless night, especially, most especially, when you are discouraged, distressed, at a loss for words, or not feeling particularly thankful. In the words of today's closing hymn, hell's foundations quiver at the shout of praise. Brothers, lift your voices, loud your anthems raise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. things come of thee, O Lord. Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
The Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who to profess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and newly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto us. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what Saint Paul saith. "This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners." Hear also what Saint John saith: "If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sin."
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he baked it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which are now offered unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils present, past, and the blessed of glories as the Virgin Mary. Through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who sit in thine apostles, on peace I live. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us.
Amen.
We see the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord, and it was my strength and my salvation. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak to it all, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak to it all. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come out of my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith, with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith.
The blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Drink this and remember that Christ's blood is shed for thee, and be thankful. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Eat and drink this and remember that Christ's blood is shed for thee, and be thankful. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Praise, blessed, and adored be our Lord Jesus Christ. On his most glorious throne in heaven, in the most holy sacrament of the altar, and in the hearts of his faith-filled people, may the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
And may light perpetual shine upon them.
Amen.